Well, it has been a mild winter in terms of both temperatures and snowfall, and according to the Minnesota DNR, that could have an effect on the deer population. Kathleen Cohen talked to the Northwest Regional Manager to find out more, as well as to take a look at the winter severity index maps.
This is just exactly what you would want to see in terms of after a couple of severe winters like this, where the deer population has been harmed by the excessive winters that we've had here.
Because the northwestern Minnesota region has seen a significantly less snowfall this winter, the snow-free grounds positively affected the mobility of deer, making it easier for them to browse and gather food.
A lot of them can survive the cold weather just fine as far as temperature goes, but obviously the worst case scenario is when you have very cold temperatures and very deep snows.
Past winter temperatures and snowfall records are broken down in the DNR's Winter Severity Index maps.
The way the index works is for every day the temperature can be measured at zero or less, a point is added. And for every day that the snow depth can be measured at 15 inches or more, a point is added.
Everything from 0 to 100 by April 1st is considered a mild winter, and everything over 180 is considered severe, where you can expect losses of deer.
So as you look here, this black area represents the 180 line. And in our area, basically our Red Lake Wildlife Management area was heavily affected from this.
But this year's map looks much more promising.
The WSI index throughout the entire state looks pretty good. A very good year, something that we need, and pretty pleased.
Reporting in Bemidji, Kathleen Cohen, Lakeland News.
The mild winter allowed for easy mobility for the deer, along with the DNR's harvest strategies. But combined, they hopefully will increase the deer population in the northwest region of the state. For more information, you can visit the Minnesota DNR's website.
If you've enjoyed this segment of Lakeland News, please consider making a tax-deductible contribution to Lakeland Public Television.